The focus of the presentation is how to track the work of MPs and MLAs in the legislative assemblies and in parliament. We start by looking at a day in parliament, and this is also very similar to how what a day in the legislative assembly looks like. Between 11 and 1 p.m., that's before lunch, is when the MP basically keeps a check on the government and represents the people. 11 to 12 is question hour. 12 to 1 is zero hour. This is when the MP raises matters of public importance, raises matters important to his constituency, and keeps the government accountable. After lunch, between 2 and 5 and 2 and 6 in the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha respectively, is when government business takes place. This is when bills are passed, when debates upon important legislative issues or issues of national importance that have debates scheduled take place. This is when the MP participates as a member of a political party or keeping the political party's ideology in mind. When talking about Parliament and the Legislative Assembly, it is important to see how often Parliament or the Legislative Assemblies meet. As the graph shows, the number of days that the Lok Sabha has been sitting has been steadily decreasing. Before 1980s, the number of days was steadily above 100. After 1980, there has seldom been a year where the number of days has exceeded 100. In fact, in 2008, the number of working days of the Lok Sabha was 46, the lowest ever so far. The number of working days in the state legislative assemblies is shown in the next graph. Most of them average to about between 40 and 50. It is interesting to note that budget session of most of these legislative assemblies is the longest, but never exceeds 30 days. The monsoon and the winter sessions are barely 5 to 10 days for each session. There has been a demand that the legislative assemblies increase the number of sitting days. When tracking the work of MPs and MLAs, it is important to see how often they go to Parliament to attend to their parliamentary duties. One way of doing this is to see their attendance. MPs are required to sign an attendance register both in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and in MLAs need to do that in legislative assemblies. This helps not only track how often they are going to Parliament, but this is also helps determine their daily allowance that is given to them. The attendance can be tracked from the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha website for MPs. Attendance for members of legislative assemblies often is not available on the respective assembly websites, but the secretariat of the assemblies will have the information and journalists could contact them to make this information available in the public domain. As the graph shows, the attendance of some of the big states in the 50 of MPs belonging to some of the big states in the 15th Lok Sabha is as follows. Because of space constraints, we've looked at some of the big states. Among these states, MPs in Kerala have the highest average attendance, averaging to about 90%. Karnataka is the lowest here, which is averaging to about 67%. It is important to see the kind of work MPs and MLAs are doing when going to Parliament or legislative assemblies. As shown before, questions is a good indicator of the kind of work that is done by them. Questions help them raise matters of public importance as well as keep how much work the government has done or how the government has performed. Question hour is usually the first hour of the day both in Parliament and in state legislative assemblies. Data on the number of questions that an MP has asked is readily available. It is available on the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha websites and as well as the website of PRS Legislative Research. Questions asked by MLAs is not so readily available on the websites of different state assemblies. However, again, this data could be requested for from the secretariat. The following graph shows the average number of questions asked by MPs from these states. As we can see, Tamil Nadu, the number of questions asked by MPs averages to about 65. Maharashtra averages to about 111. The way that the questions are chosen in the Lok Sabha is through a ballot. MPs are required to give the questions they want to ask into a ballot, after which it is chosen. It is not necessary that all questions that are given into the ballot are chosen. The national average of number of questions asked is 62. So far, we've been talking about the role of an MP in terms of how he or she keeps the government in check. Thereafter, we'll talk about their participation in debates, which more or less has to be along party lines. Now, there are a variety of debates that an MP and MLA participates in. This has got to do with participating in debates related to budget, related to passage of bills, related to discussion on matters of public importance. The text of this debate is available on the website of the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha where Parliament is concerned. This information can also be requested from the state legislative assemblies. In the following graph, one can see the average debate participation of MPs of the following states. For example, MPs in Tamil Nadu have participated on an average in 10 debates. MPs from Kerala have participated on an average of 17 debates. In the graph, one can see that Karnataka has the lowest average participation in debates, which is 3. Now, when we're looking at both the number of questions and the number of debates that an MP has asked or participated in, it is important to go beyond the numbers. A, it is important to see how often the MP or MLA participates in his parliamentary or legislative functions, but it is also important to see the substance. One can see the kinds of questions and the kinds of debates that the MP has participated in looking at the debate text or looking at the question or debate text from the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha websites. It is important to see, for instance, whether the questions are related to the MP's constituency, the MP's state, or looking at national level policy issues. Similarly, in debates, it is important to see the kind of debates that the MP has participated in, whether they are concerned with the MP's state, concerned with flagship policies of the government, concerned with centrally sponsored schemes, or the kind of bill debates that the MP has participated in. For bill debates, of course, it is important to realize that the MP cannot take his own initiative always. The MP is often asked by his or her political party to participate in the debate. The national average of debate participation is 8 debates. When looking at the working of Parliament or of legislative assemblies, it is important to see the legislative business that has been carried out. One way of doing that, of course, is the number of bills that have been passed, both by Parliament or by the legislative assembly. For bills passed by Parliament, one can see that the graph is steadily averaging to about 60 bills on an average in a year. This, of course, changes from government to government, depending on the government's policies, depending on the focus of the government, and depending on the number on the sectors that the government seeks to focus on. When looking at passage of bills, it is not only important to look at the number of bills that has been passed, but it is also important to see the kind of bills that has been passed, as well as the time spent on discussing and debating each bill. Lawmaking processes in India need to be focused on more diligently by both the press as well as parliamentarians and members of legislative assemblies. Time spent on a bill indicates the focus, the energy, the research that has gone into looking at the various issues that the bill seeks to address and the voices of stakeholders that have been incorporated into the process. Another thing that can be seen when looking at the work of an MP or an MLA is looking at the utilization of the local area development funds that is allotted to them. Each member of parliament gets 2 crores to spend on his or her constituency in a year. Details of how he or she spends them can be seen from a website called www.mplads.nic.in. This website is maintained by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. This website enables us to look at the kind of projects that has been initiated by the MP for utilization of his or her MP LAD funds, as well as the time spent and amount sanctioned. This website is updated on a regular basis by district collectors from the area that the MP focuses on. Annual reports of the ministry are also available on this website, which help us look at different sectors that the money has been spent on. The MP LAD website provides report about how the money has been utilized in this format. Over here you can see how MP LAD fund has been utilized by this particular member of parliament from the 14th Lok Sabha. This shows the name of the project, the date of sanction of the project, the cost sanctioned for the project, target date for completion, as well as the agency that has been chosen to execute the project. Of course, there are various sources that can be accessed when looking at the work of MPs, MLAs, Parliament, as well as legislative assemblies. The Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha website are important resources. They help us look at track members' attendance, they help us track the kind of questions members ask, as well as the kind of debates that are participated in. These are updated on a regular basis when Parliament is in session. Most assemblies also have functional websites. they provide details about the rules and procedures of the assemblies as well as the kind of work that is undertaken by assemblies. Of course, it also depends on how often these are updated and how information that's updated can be utilized. The URL for the Lok Sabha website is www.loksabha.nic.in. The URL for the Rajya Sabha website is www.rajyasabha.nic.in. The Election Commission of India is another important website that helps us track affidavits of electoral representatives at the time of election. These affidavits provide data about the person's education qualifications as well as their assets and liabilities. These are useful resources, especially during election time, to look at details about candidates. These are available on www.eci.nic.in. The websites to help track the utilization of funds allotted under the MPLADS scheme is www.mplads.nic.in. Another important resource for journalists is the Press Information Bureau website. This helps track the bills that come into Parliament before they come into Parliament and also help look at certain questions that have been asked in Parliament or any important schemes that the government is planning to introduce. That is www.pib.nic.in. For any further information on the data or analysis on Parliament legislation activity of MPs, please contact us at www.prsindia.org.